The case of today is for a lady, 6-7 years old. A patient presented with severe abdominal pain. The clinician requested a CT scan to rule out what is the cause of this abdominal pain. CT was done with intravenous contrast administration, and the findings are
So this is a CT study done for the patient with intravenous contrast administration. So what are the findings? This is the liver here, normal, smooth outline, homogeneous density. But here in the left biliary tree, we can appreciate that we have pneumobilia, as you see here. If we magnify the image a little bit like this, yeah, this is the pneumobilia here. So this is air in the biliary system. And if we go more down, we can appreciate also that we have some gas inside the gallbladder. So from this image, we have gas in the gallbladder as well as gas or air in the left biliary tree, what is known as pneumobilia. If we go more down, we can appreciate we have small bowel dilatation. We have marked the small bowel dilatation. These are the small bowels located in the center of the abdomen here. This is the descending colon. This one is the ascending colon. So these are dilated small bowel lobes. The wall of the small bowel lobes is normal, is of normal thickness, not thickened, with normal enhancement, with no evidence of intramural gas to suggest a possibility of choroidal mesenteric ischemia. As well as you can appreciate normal enhancement of the mesenteric vessels. This is a superior mesenteric artery. This one is a superior mesenteric vein. No evidence of any filling defect could be seen. If we go down to the region of the lower abdomen, this is the ascending colon, ascending colon, ascending colon. This is the cecum here. And this one is the terminal ileum. So the terminal ileum and the distal part of distal ileal loop here is of normal caliber. Compare between this dilated small bowel and the adjacent one of normal caliber distal ileal lobes. So we have to trace the distal ileal lobes until reaching to the transition zone representing the region of obstruction. This pattern of small bowel dilatation suggesting mechanical small bowel obstruction. Okay, so if we trace the distal ileal lobes, we can define here now this is a transitional zone, and we have here an intraluminal calcular shadow giving signet ring appearance. This is a characteristic appearance of gallbladder stone. So this is ectopic gallbladder stone obstructing the distal part of the small bowel, causing marked proximal small bowel dilatation in addition to presence of pneumobilia and also gas in the gallbladder.
If we summarize the finding together, what do we have? We have pneumobilia or aerobilia or air in the biliary tree and air also in the gallbladder. We have also obstruction of a small bowel with a small bowel dilatation by an ectopic gallbladder stone. These three findings or this triad is known as Regler's triad or gallstone ileus. So what is the gallstone ileus? Gallstone ileus, this is a complication of chronic cholecystitis due to adhesions between the gallbladder and the adjacent small bowel loop, most probably the duodenum. Due to these adhesions between the gallbladder and the duodenum, fistulation can happen. And the gallbladder stone can escape through this fistulation to the small bowel, passing through the small bowel until obstructing the bowel in its narrowest part, which is the distal part of the small bowel, causing a small bowel obstruction and dilatation. So, what are the regular triads or what is the gallstone ileus? It's a triad of pneumobilia, small bowel dilatation due to obstruction by an ectopic gallbladder stone. Thank you very much.